Hi, and welcome to the Rancher Mike YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be talking about a topic that gets a lot of questions on YouTube, and that is, how do you actually move beetles in your mealworm colony? Now, for those of you who aren't familiar with my mealworm colony, which you see behind me, I have other videos that you can check out by clicking the links above. One of those videos talks about how I designed my system. The other one goes into detail on how I actually move pupa and beetles within my system, kind of my strategy for making sure that the pupa can develop into beetles without stress or damage, and also that the beetles don't attack the eggs that they're laying so that those eggs can develop into mealworms, which is the whole point of having your system set up this way so that you can keep a constant supply of mealworms in your mealworm colony. So if you're interested, check out the links above. But today, I'm going to be focusing on the actual process for moving beetles from one bin to another. And so for those of you who haven't watched my other videos, generally speaking, once my beetles are in a mature phase of development, I try to move them from one bin to another about every couple of weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. That gives them ample time to lay eggs in the bin in which they are currently. And if you leave them any longer than that, they start to actually attack the eggs in some cases. And that will, of course, drive down the efficiency of your mealworm colony. So to avoid that, I move them to the next bin about every 2 to 3 weeks, and it is time to do that. So I thought I would do a video to show you my process for moving the beetles. Now, my process allows me to not only move the beetles from one bin to another, it allows me to keep all of the food substrate that is left behind with the eggs in the bin where the beetles are right now. And it also allows me to separate the dead beetles from the live beetles, which is something that a lot of you struggle with. And so without further ado, let's go ahead and get after it. First of all, I have a strainer that I bought off of Amazon. If you've seen my other videos, I describe this in those videos. You can also find a link to these products that you can buy on Amazon below in the description of this video. I have an Amazon storefront link where I have curated a lot of the items you see in my videos, and you'll find these in the section called mealworm farming in my Amazon storefront. I have that ready with a 5-gallon bucket beneath it so that I can separate the beetles from the food substrate. I also have my labeling device, which I have described before as well. This is an Epson LW400. Again, you can find a link to that in my Amazon storefront. And I also have a set of vinyl gloves ready to go. These are food grade vinyl gloves. And I use these when I'm transferring beetles, not because I'm squeamish. As you've seen in my other videos, I have no problem touching the beetles and everything else. I only find that when I'm moving beetles that they scramble so much to get away from the light that they'll start crawling up your arm if you don't have something covering your hands. So to prevent that, I use these vinyl gloves, and I find that it works really well. In addition to the bin that we're going to be separating the beetles from here, which I'll get in a minute, I have 2 extra bins ready to go because I need 3 in total when I'm doing the process that I use. I also have this piece of egg flat that I cut down. Normally the egg flat is, I think, like a 12 by 12. I cut it down just a little bit so that it fits inside the bin that I use. I bought these egg flats to use for collecting eggs for my chickens. I just took one, cut off one side, and then it fits in the bin, and I will show you how I use that here in a minute. All right, as I said, I usually wait a couple of weeks to move beetles from one bin to another. These here are dated on March 26th. It is now around April 9th, and so it's time to move these beetles out of here. So the first thing you're gonna notice is that I have this structure on top, and you're probably wondering what it is if you haven't seen my other videos. Well, briefly, this is what I use to put pupa on top when I am moving pupa from my mealworm bins before they develop into beetles. I put them on top here. As you can see, there's 4 right now that are almost developed fully into beetles. This one's very close, so that's kind of neat to see how they look when they're almost fully transformed. And so when they're in this stage and they're trying to get out of that last pupa stage, I like to have them separated from the beetles so the beetles don't start to attack them, and they can therefore develop fully without any stress or damage. So I had a friend build for me this metal structure. I've discussed it in my other videos, which you can find a link to above. So I'm not going to go into that in any more detail now. I moved this structure out of the bin and I put it off to the side so that I can have it ready to go in the final bin when I'm ready to do that. So here you see the beetles left in the bin. Now the problem is that you have live beetles mixed in with dead beetles. You also have the source of moisture, the carrots in this case, and of course the food substrate. So many of you ask, how do you get the live beetles separated from everything else? Well, it's actually quite simple, and I'm going to show you now. The first thing that I do is to put on the vinyl gloves. As I said, it prevents the beetles from sticking to my hands and also from climbing up my arms. I first take out the carrots as best I can, and you can see how easy that is. I then take the bin and pour everything into the circular strainer. All of the food substrate, which also contains the eggs, will fall through the strainer to the bottom inside the 5-gallon bucket, and everything left on top will be the live beetles mixed in with the dead beetles and, I hate to say it, dead beetle parts. I then take the strainer and pour it over the egg flat in small batches. The reason that I don't want to overload the egg flat is because I want the live beetles to stick to it, and the dead beetles, of course, won't be able to. So then I can turn the egg flat over and shake it gently in the third bin that I have set up, and now you see why I needed three bins, and I can release all of the live beetles. I will then do this again in several stages, trying to make sure that I fill in all the little cups of the egg flat, turn it over gently so that the dead beetles are released, and shake vigorously in the third bin. You will notice that some of the beetles will also stick to the backside, so you got to be careful. Some may also stick on the front, so you're going to have to, you know, inspect it every time to make sure you don't have beetles just going everywhere in your workspace. And then with one final effort, I turn it over. Now you'll notice that there are some live beetles stuck to the strainer. Well, instead of tapping those into the second bin, I just go ahead and tap those straight into the third, since I know that if they're sticking to the strainer, they're live. I then gently turn the egg flat over one more time. Now you'll see there are some beetles on the bottom, but I gently shake those on either side. And then what's left, I move to the base of the second bin and use my hands to put them on top of the egg flat. This is where a glove also helps. And I will repeat this process once or twice more. Live beetles will stick, dead beetles won't. Shake it in the third bin. And what you're left with is primarily dead beetles in the second bin, and you can hand pick out the rest that are still alive. And here you see you're left with all dead beetles in one and all live beetles in the other.
And then everything in here that is left is the food substrate with all of the eggs. Now you can also see that there are eggs in the bin. All those little specks that you see are actually little egg clusters mixed in with food. So what I will do then is I will take this off and make sure that I wash this later, because it's going to probably have some eggs attached to it as well. I'll take my 5-gallon bucket, pour it back into the original bin, try to shake out as much as I can, because again, if there's any eggs stuck to the bucket, you want to make sure you get all of those into your bin. And then here you go. So this is now going to be left in here to grow into tiny mealworms, and I can spread it out with my glove. And again, all of that food substrate and eggs is not going to stick to my glove as easily as it would to my fingers without the glove on. So that's good. I will take the dead beetles and put them in a bucket that I can then feed to my chickens later, because nothing goes to waste in my mealworm colony if I can help it. And now I have the live beetles ready for another couple of weeks.
The next thing I'll do is add a few scoops of heat-treated wheat bran. If you've seen my other videos, you know that I always heat-treat my wheat bran when I buy it from the store. I don't just put it in my bins immediately. That is to kill any grain mites or grain mite eggs that might be in there.
And then I'll just kind of spread the wheat bran around a little bit, make sure that it gets all the beetles covered because they like to be in the dark. This bin is done. I'm done using it, but I'm gonna make sure that I wash it later. So I'll put that to the side. And then I will take this that has the pupa on it. And because it's kind of heavy, I'll make sure that I clear space in the bin for it first, get all the beetles out of the way so they don't get crushed underneath. And I will kind of just nestle it in and then do the same on the other side. Just kind of slowly let it work its way down so I don't crush any beetles underneath. They can get out of the way. And there you have it. I'll add a couple of carrots to this just so they have additional moisture in there. Put the lid on, put it back in my colony system, and I will give it a label. So the one that the beetles came out of, I don't put carrots in just yet. I wait until the mealworms get to be sufficiently large that I can start to see the sheddings of their exoskeletons from the moultings. Then I know that they're getting sufficiently large that they probably need additional moisture that they can't get out of the air. So this is where the beetles were originally. You can see beetles went in. I'm gonna go ahead and make a label that says beetles out. All right, so you see there, beetles out on 4/9/21, and I'm gonna put that off to the right. So this bin goes back right beneath the one before it. So here the beetles came out on March 26th. Here they came in on March 26th and they went out on April 9th. And then to this tray that has the beetles in it, I will add beetles in on the same date today. And then I'll put this in the rack system right beneath the other one. And then I know that in another couple of weeks, I need to move these beetles to the next bin beneath.
Then, as I mentioned earlier, I took the strainer, the extra bin, and the 5-gallon bucket outside and sprayed them with Clorox and soapy water and rinsed them really well to make sure that if there were any residual eggs clinging to any of those surfaces, they wouldn't develop into little tiny mealworms and start crawling around my workspace later.
After washing the bucket and strainer and the other bin, what I will finally do is put the piece of egg crate that I used to transfer the beetles into a separate bin. The reason I do that is if there's any eggs attached to this egg flat from me moving the beetles and those eggs start to develop into mealworms, they'll do so in this bin and not out in my garage, you know, where the mealworms can just crawl off somewhere. So I always like to store it kind of in one of my empty bins so that if there's any mealworms developing from that, I can see them in there and I can move them to the appropriate bin later on.
So there you have it. That's how I transfer beetles in my mealworm colony when it's time to move them. Like I said, every 2 to 3 weeks, those beetles will stay in the new bin for those next 2 to 3 weeks and lay eggs in there, and then I'll move them again. And of course, I will keep track of all of those movements with my labeling system, which is very important. And if you do that, what you should end up with are bins where your eggs are lower and smaller mealworms are a little higher yet, and a little bit bigger mealworms as you go up a particular column. So I wanted to show you, this is a bin that the beetles were taken out in February, late February of this year. So it's been about a month and a few days since these beetles were taken out. And you can see in here, the first thing you'll notice is that there's a lot of exoskeletons from the mealworms on top. Well, that's a good sign. That means your mealworms are molting and growing. But I probably need to clean those up a little bit with my vacuum system. And I've got another video that I'll post a link above on how to clean up your bins as well. But if I search through here, you can see that there are quite a few mealworms in here that are getting to be pretty big. If you can see that there. Now, not all the mealworms are growing at the same rate. You're going to have some that are a little bit bigger than others. But I am getting to the point where in the next probably 1 to 2 weeks or so, there will be several in here that I can harvest and feed to my chickens, which is why I grow mealworms to begin with. I don't just do it for a hobby. I actually do it as another source of protein for my animals. And I'm sure you all do as well. So time is coming for me to start to harvest from this bin here soon. I will, of course, keep some mealworms back and let those turn into pupa, and those pupa will ultimately turn into beetles. The beetles will lay eggs, and you can see how the cycle continues. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, go smash that like button, click subscribe, and also ring the notification bell to be informed of new content whenever I release new videos, which happens quite often. And if you're looking for other content on mealworms, check out some of my other videos where I talk about a lot of different topics related to mealworm farming. So if you're curious, go seek those out. I'm sure you'll find them equally informative, at least I hope so. And if you have any content that you would like to see on my YouTube channel, or you have any questions or other comments, feel free to leave those below. I try to get back to as many of those as I can in a timely manner, because I know that this is important to you all, and so I want to make sure that I can answer any questions that you may have. Thanks again for watching, and until next time, take care.